Okay, without further ado, I'm going to bring up Jack Lynch from Bachmann Industries. He's going to tell you about all the wonderful new products that they have. Jack, you want to get up here?
Hi, my name's Jack Lynch. I'm the General Manager Special Projects at Bachmann Industries in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, right up the road here. We're here. I'd like to thank the TCA folks for having us. It's really a pleasure to come and present new products to everybody at the show here. It's nice to be here at the fall TCA event. I know most of the folks here are interested in 3-rail-O, so we'll do a little bit of that here first. Our newest product in the Williams line of 3-rail-O is our 460. Excuse me one sec. Gotta get my cheat sheet. 460 locomotives are basically what I consider the cornerstone of our company. We make 460s now in N scale, HO, ON30, O scale, and large scale. Really, really iconic American locomotive. You can run it with passenger, you can run it with freight. The four road names we're doing as the initial release are Union Pacific, we put a Greyhound scheme on it. Southern Green, which personally I think is the prettiest engine of the bunch. I think it's got a lot of personality. Make a really nice passenger set. Locomotive that some of you might be familiar with that Larry Harrington of Williams tells me is right down the road here at the B&O Museum is a CNO version of the 460. Very colorful, Russian iron boiler, lots of detail, lots of trim. Really pretty, pretty locomotive. And last but not least, hate to call it plain Jane, but Santa Fe version, black. Not much more you can say about that, but very pretty locomotive. The 460s feature, boy, that sounds really loud. The 460s will run on 027 as well as O-gauge track. They'll navigate an 027 curve. They feature a die-cast boiler and chassis. It's an injection molded tender. Feature traction tires. They feature a flywheel. Operating headlight, operating coupler, manual coupler, operating smoke unit, and whistle and bell. So that's the 460. It's a very, very nice piece. And I can picture these coming down the line in various things, individual sales sets, things of that nature. Another product that a lot of people are interested in, and we've gotten a lot of good positive feedback on, is what we're referring to as Easy Street. Easy Street is a product that a lot of you are familiar with. I've got a couple samples of the track pieces here. I've also got a couple of vans that we painted up. We painted up the Bachmann van, which if you come to York, you may have seen this van floating around up the road. We bring our stuff to the show in the Bachmann van. And we also did a Plasticville van, which I think is really cool. You can park that with your Plasticville buildings around the layout. I'm running around on Easy Street. A piece that a lot of people have been asking about the paint scheme on, that we finally have production samples on, is the Bicentennial GG1. Nice scale piece. Not everyone's cup of tea, but if you like really, really outrageous paint schemes, really bright, colorful things, this is right up your alley. Based on an actual paint scheme from the Bicentennial in 1976, there it is. You can come by the booth, take a look at it. Another piece that's coming back this year in a new paint scheme is the Peter Witt Trolley. We had a lot of requests for a PTC paint scheme, a Philadelphia Transit Corporation paint scheme. So there it is. They actually still run PC, it's a Peter Witt, they actually run PCC cars in Philadelphia near Bachmann, and we've gone down and looked at those and gone to the SEPTA building and looked at the PCC car there and looked at the greens and matched it up. So it's a very, very nice piece, very attractive, close to our heart. Next thing I'd like to talk about are our accessory lines. We're making an effort to help the modeler build his layout away from his trains and do a little more scenic work on the layout. One of the items we have here is a nice set of lated barricades. And what I did was I took the barricade out of the package here and mounted it on a base with some of our Scenescapes figures. Came out really nice. I think it's really, really a nice piece. The figures scale out really nicely with these pieces. And we'll be doing a few more items like this as well. Also, some of the new street lamps that we're reintroducing, obviously lighted street lamps, plastic, injection molded, very nice pieces. We're also bringing out some operating accessories like this operating billboard. You have a little guy on there that's got his I guess you'd call it a brush or a tool to put up, you know, the billboard signage. So he moves up and down as you operate the accessories. We have that coming out. In our Scenescapes lines, we do a lot of trees and foliage and gravel and dirt, the things you really need to finish off your layout. We have some new trees this year that came out really well. We're doing a set of blue spruce trees. So we have blue spruce in different sizes. We've got various sizes like that. I think they come in 3, 4, and 6 inch. I could be wrong. Yeah, 3 to 4 inch, 8 to 10 inch, and 6 to 8 inch. So you have three different size trees for different scales. You can use them for NHO or O gauge. What we also did this year is we went ahead and did bulk packaging on the trees. Because, you know, when you go into the hobby store and you buy a pack of trees, you've got three trees. You take them home, you put them on your layout, and you go, where's the forest? You know, I'm stuck with three little trees. So what we did was we went ahead and started to bulk package our trees, which is really nice. I'd like to give you a count on them, but I think there's probably about a dozen trees or more in here in the package. So we did each different size tree in a bulk pack. We did conifers, we did cedars, we did pine trees with snow in different size packets, different size trees in various packets. I think this is an exciting product in the sense that you can go out and buy 4 or 5 packs of these and do a really nice forest. You know, you're not stuck buying, 100 boxes of trees. Those are really nice. Excited about those. We're also repackaging a lot of track sections. We have new operating track sections in the William line for 0 and 027 for your operating cars or for your coupler, coupling and uncoupling. So those are new. They're coming out. We're also issuing packages of track connectors, lock-ons, insulated track pins, metal track pins for those of you that still use tubular track. So we're putting out all the little pieces that you need to complete your track layout. I think that's pretty much what I have. I also have a new O-scale skeleton log car in the Williams line, and we're doing these in three different road names, which would be Northern Pacific, Canadian Pacific, and Spokane, Portland, and Seattle. So these are really, really nice cars. I encourage you to come on up and take a look at these guys if you have a chance. I'll sit that right there. Now, something that I really like. I started out in O-gauge. I always did 3-rail O. My father had Lionel trains. We always had them up at Christmas time. Love O-gauge. Something I've discovered since I've been at Bachmann that I never really realized existed was O-scale narrow gauge trains. O-scale narrow gauge, or ON30, and the designation ON30 stands for O-scale narrow gauge 30-inch track gauge. So basically, you're looking at the same scale train. I mean, it's a 148 scale train, but when you look at the wheelbase, it's much more narrow. The nice thing about these trains is they basically run, they run on HO scale track. Now, the real purists in this gauge go out and buy track with, wider space ties and longer ties so that it looks like actual narrow gauge track. But you can use Bachmann Easy Track, regular HO track, and run these O-scale trains in a much smaller area than you need for your standard 3-rail O. 3-rail O, minimum, I've always felt was 4x8. You have to use a 4x8. 4x8 gets you an oval, maybe a switch or a passing or whatever. You go ON30 and you use a 4x8, you can build a mountain. I mean, you can build a mining town or, a logging town with these things. Plus, they're all DCC equipped. They all have DCC decoders and sound in them, 16-bit sound. Just phenomenal little pieces. And we've kind of concentrated on logging and mining, where you get the more interesting locomotives like the Climaxes and the Heislers and the Shays, where you've got a lot of gearing and a lot of articulation going on. They're very interesting little trains. But like I said, they're 148 scale. You can use your O-scale people, your O-scale buildings. These guys fit right in there with it. And you can do so much on a small area. And you can also incorporate these into your O-scale layout by building a mine or building a logging area or something like that. And that way you've got two different things going on and variations, but varieties to spice of life. So I encourage you to stop by our booth. I've got a nice big display at ON30. The other new ON30 locomotive, besides this Heisler, we're reissuing our Porter locomotive, which, if you're familiar with Porters, they're probably the smallest steam engines out there. They're little teeny tiny saddle tank locos. And what we did with our Porter was, for the first time, we've put sound and DCC in these Porters, which are, I mean, the Porter's half the size of this loco here. And we went ahead and we did something new with the sound. We took an exciter, which is the little speaker that's in your cell phone, and we mounted that into the cab. And the Porter uses the actual cab of the locomotive as the amplifier for this little speaker, or I should say exciter, that's mounted into the cab. And it sounds really great, and it's tiny. I mean, you just can't believe we fit the electronics into this thing. So stop and look at the Porters, look at the Heisler, look at the 460s. I'm trying to think if I have any. I think that's everything I've got. So I brought some catalogs. I have them over here on the side table. If you guys didn't get one in the spring, there. The new catalog will be out in February at Toy Fair. Let me look at my list once really quick. We have one other product, and I don't know. I want to ask by show of hands. Is there anybody here that does N-scale, HO, anything other than O-gauge? I got one guy, so this isn't going to be really good for any of you. we have a relationship with Soundtrax Sound in Durango, Colorado, who make, in my opinion, probably the best sound out there for model railroading. And we are taking, you know, the Soundtrax Sound is migrating into different product lines. We originally had it in our Spectrum HO gauge, strictly in HO Spectrum. We're moving it around. I'm not going to say anything until the spring where else it's going, but we're also doing economy sound in our HO gauge locos now, which means it's called Value Sound. Value Sound is a 16-bit sound system that's integrated into the locomotives at a really, really economical price point. So if anybody's interested in HO or in any of the other gauges, and I wouldn't be surprised to see it go other places in the future. We're trying to make sound a lot more economical. And if you get a chance, go to Soundtrax's website and listen to their sound. I mean, it's just phenomenal stuff. But I guess that's about it. Unless anybody has any questions, I'm pretty much done. That's the new products. I encourage everybody to come by the booth, talk to Larry Harrington, our Williams rep, about the Williams products if you have questions. And there's a lot more coming in the spring. So, okay, thank you.